There's a reason work smart, not hard is a cliche. Effective studying more about how you study, not just how long. Studying TV focuses on getting the most out of every study session, and you should too. But for now, today's video.
The question, what is the best study environment? I think an efficient study environment consists of eight basic components. One, order and cleanliness. Start by organizing your desk. Remove everything that isn't associated with studying. Also, make sure that the surrounding environment is clean. Feng shui, and the productivity that comes with it, will instantly increase by at least 130%. Remove everything that isn't associated with studying. Also, make sure that the surrounding environment is clean. Feng shui. There might, and probably will, be some papers and notes laying on your desk after you're done the cleaning. Gather all the papers in one big pile, leaf through them and then organize them in the following way. Pile 1, things needing completion, take action. Pile 2, items to file away. Pile 3, trash. And after this, yep, you guessed it, throw pile 3 to the garbage bin. File documents from pile 2 to folders and cases. Attack pile 1, starting from the first paper on the pile. Repeat the process every time you start studying. Throw pile 3 to the garbage bin. File documents from pile 2 to folders and cases. Attack pile 1, starting from the first paper on the pile. You can also try decorating your study space. Inspirational quotes or lively photos might increase your motivation to study. Pleasant colors, such as blue, purple and green, are associated with peace and balance. Just don't overdo it. You can also try decorating your study space, too. Lighting. Research suggests that cool, bluish-white lighting, 6500K, is the best choice for studying. This kind of lighting mimics natural daylight and increases your alertness. Cool, bluish-white lighting, 6500K, is the best choice for studying. Of course, you could also try studying in natural light whenever possible. Pay attention to lighting every time you start studying. Is the sun about to set? Does the light cover all my study material? Are there any distracting shadows or reflections? 3. Smells. Not all distractions are unpleasant. For example, the smell of freshly baked pizza from downstairs might be enough to ruin your study session. This is also a distraction you might not be able to eliminate. What to do when all you can think of is pizza instead of the complex math equation in front of you? Pick up and move. When you can't eliminate the distractions, change the environment. Pick up and move. 4. Time. Find your prime time. There are certain hours in the day when you will be able to write, read and learn more effectively than others. Find those hours and emphasize them. Find your prime time. Also, consider placing a clock on your desk. It might give you a sense of urgency and can help you achieve time-related goals. Use the clock to keep you moving forward, efficiently. Consider placing a clock on your desk. 5. Temperature. When you can control the surrounding environment, e.g., with a thermostat, set the temperature to a comfortable, constant level. When studying at a library or a public place, try to have extra clothing, if it's too cold, or ice or water, if it is too warm, handy. An environment that is too cold or too warm may not appear alarming at first. But rest assured, after a while it will become the only thing you can think of. So prepare yourself accordingly. Other people. Study groups can be tremendously effective, or they can just be a waste of time. If you want to study in a group, set clear goals and an agenda for the session. Make sure that everyone in the group is aware of these goals and commits to them. If, on the other hand, you want to study alone, make sure everyone knows you're studying. A simple do not disturb door hanger can do wonders for your study session. If you're studying in public, seek for either a quiet corner table or a spot right in the middle of it all. Why so? You might not be able to find a quiet corner table, and in these situations, it's better to find a spot where there are so much noise and buzz that you won't get distracted by one conversation. 7. Comfortability. An efficient study environment cannot be too comfortable. It might seem like a good idea to lay on your bed while doing homework, but it can easily lead to loss of focus and increased tiredness. Your brain is preparing you for a nap, not for studying. An efficient study environment cannot be too comfortable. Usually, the best option is to sit at a desk or a table with a comfortable chair. It's even better if you can adjust the height of both of these. If you do own an electric table, consider alternating between sitting and standing while studying. 8. Other distractions. 8. Other distractions. Devote your desk or study space only for studying. A separate study space creates a clear boundary between working and free time. This space also acts as an indication, you should not be disturbed while you're in this space. Devote your desk or study space only for studying. Forget your phone. Keep it away from your study space, preferably in another room. If you're using a phone as a calculator, put it in airplane mode. Use it as a reward during breaks. Forget your phone. Reduce desk clutter during your study breaks. You should only have the material needed for studying in front of you. Reduce desk clutter during your study breaks. Use earplugs to block noises. Erratic, repeating noises can wreck your focus. Use earplugs to block noises. Don't consume too much caffeine or sugar. Indeed, they do give you that brief ecstasy, but they also lead to crashes. Rather, drink water and eat fresh fruit. Don't consume too much caffeine or sugar. Set strict time frames for meal breaks. Meal breaks tend to stretch longer than expected if you haven't set a specific time frame for each break. Stick to your schedule. Set strict time frames for meal breaks. Stick to your schedule. Hope this helps. Further questions? Email me, John. T. Elliott, Student D. 5.